It's April, and you know what that means.
Another 30 days inside the ship.
No, it's Aliens Month, you dumb pink. For those of you who are new to this channel, I dedicate every April to discussion of what I call wild science-y alien theories, megastructures, events, discoveries, science fiction concepts, whatever I can pull out of my ass. Not literally pulling things out of my ass, by the way. That's disgusting. This year's Aliens Month is going to be a continuation of last year's, sort of. So if you want to get caught up, I'll have a playlist linked up there in that corner, as well as in the description. So go ahead and check that out, then come back here. Assuming you've already caught up, we'll be starting this year's Aliens Month by moving on from making a sphere of you to a ring of you. Depending on what media you've been exposed to, you might actually be familiar with this structure already. I'm sure everyone's heard of Halo. I'm Vibby, and on this episode of A Space Alien Explains, the Niven Ring. Or you might recognize it by its more popular name, Ringworld. The concept of a Ringworld was written by sci-fi author Larry Niven in his 1970 novel, you'll never guess what it's f***ing called, Ringworld. As an interesting side note, Larry Niven once wrote an essay where he uses real-world physics to detail the difficulties Superman might have if he were to mate with a human woman, and it's so goddamn weird. A Niven ring is an artificial ring that encircles a star. The inner side of the ring is a nice comfy landmass for the inhabitants to live, while the outer side would protect them from all the nasty space stuff. As a large population continues to grow, the shrinking amount of living space on a planet may become a concern. A Niven ring would be able to provide more land than you could ever hope to figure out what to do with. Overpopulation situation? Put a ring on it. The Niven ring actually draws a lot of inspiration from the Dyson Sphere, so you'll see a lot of similarities. So now that you know what a Niven ring is and why you might even need one, how does one go about making such a gargantuan structure? Much like our Dyson Sphere, an army of robots would be the best bet when it comes to performing the actual construction. But Ringworlds don't happen by disassembling the Earth and then reassembling it into stellar SpaghettiOs. You're gonna need a butt metric load of more rocks than that. Luckily for you, you've got more than enough material just chilling in your backyard. Not your literal backyard, I meant like your space backyard. A pebble you found in your garden a Ringworld does not make. So I know this place past Neptune, but you guys call it the Kuiper Belt. It's a region stretching about 1.86 billion miles, filled with all kinds of icy bodies. To be clear, when I say icy bodies, I mean asteroids. There is no 2 billion mile ring of corpses up there past Neptune. And if there is, I'm gonna have a lot of questions. I digress, but there's a gold mine of raw materials out there. Like, there's so much in the Kuiper Belt, you could build whatever you goddamn well please. So you have your materials and construction can begin. But you'll come across your next problem rather quickly. The sheer size of the Ringworld itself. The structure will end up being so enormous, it would break any known molecular bonds. I almost read that as bongs. I know it's tempting, but please don't build anything with bongs. Either you'd have to create a new super strong material, or you'd have to make use of strong nuclear force. Of all forces, it's the most grabby-grabby, since it bonds materials on the scale of the atomic nucleus, and virtually nothing will break it apart. If you can't find a way to keep everything together, any pebble passing through your solar system is gonna f*** up your ring and it'll be a bad time. But assuming you can keep your Niven ring in one piece, the next problem would be generating gravity. An easy problem to fix, to be honest. Just spin that b***h. You'd have to spin it 1,200,000 miles an hour, which sounds really fast, but you'd generate enough centrifugal force to create gravity equal to what's on Earth. Also, you'd have to be really careful to distribute your rotational forces evenly, or else the whole thing will just rip itself apart. Which is also a bad time. But there's no friction in space, so once you get it spinning to the right speed, it'll pretty much stay like that forever. So, you know, just don't f*** up. Once you have gravity, you can start bringing in an atmosphere, and then of course, people. Since the inner side of the ring will always be facing the sun, it'll be daytime 24/7. If you really wanted some nighttime cycles, the best way to do that would be to install another ring of panels inside the Ringworld. And as a bonus, you can use those panels to absorb energy from the sun. As epic as a Niven ring might sound, it's actually more unstable than that crackhead hanging out behind the Denny's you've been trying so hard to avoid. Something punched a hole in your ring? There goes your atmosphere. Asteroid gave it a little nudge? Guess we're gonna meet the sun up close. One solar flare happened? Millions are dead. Despite the many potential issues, the idea of Ringworlds have stirred the human imagination. Video game series Halo features smaller versions of the Niven Ring, and the 2013 film Elysium has a Ringworld that circles the Earth. FYI, planetary-scale Niven Rings are also known as Bishop Rings, Orbitals, or Halos. Larry Niven himself has pointed out that Ringworlds are great for telling a story, but not so much for solving an overpopulation problem. There's definitely bigger and better things you could build. Or you could avoid the overpopulation thing entirely by not f***ing so goddamn much. Hi everyone, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this episode. This week's featured fan art is by InfiniteStyle5 on Twitter. Link to the artist's page is in the description. And here's some comments from the last video. If this episode made you want to build a massive unstable ring for literally no reason, please be sure to drop a like and hit that subscribe button if you want to see more content like this. If you'd like to support the channel, I have art commissions and a Ko-fi page available. Buy me a coffee and I can make you a sketch as a way of saying thanks. Links to all that, as well as links to my social media, are in the description. Thank you so much again for watching, and I'll see you real soon.